ओके, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू पीपल आर डूइंग फाइन इन योर होम. ओके, सो इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल वी विल जस्ट लुक इनटू द अदर पार्ट्स विच आर देयर इन टाइमर वन. ओके, सो इन प्रीवियस ट्यूटोरियल वी हैव सीन रिलेटेड टू आईसीयू यूनिट, सो इन विच वी केम टू नो दैट द आईसीयू इज यूज फॉर कैप्चरिंग द टाइमर काउंट वैल्यू. ओके, so in this tutorial we just learn what is the role of this OCU, that is output compare unit, which is available inside this timer 1, right? Now this timer 1 module has an integrated module, as I told earlier. So it has an integrated module named input capture unit, output compare unit, and as well as your timer 1 can also be used as your normal timer, which can provide with delay, and as well as you can also use it for counter. Okay, the same way which we dealt in your timer 0. The only difference for this mode, that is your timer and counter, with respect to your timer 1 as compared to timer 0, is that your timer 0 is of 8 bit and this timer 1 is of 16 bit. Okay, so this timer and counter mode you already know, so we'll just skip this. And this input capture unit we already dealt with in with this particular module in previous session. So today we'll just look into the role of this output compare unit and what all stuffs we can do by using this output compare unit. So that is what we will deal with, right? Okay, now when you consider your timer 1 module, you know, so basically with respect to your Atmega 8, so you have 4 pins involved with respect to timer 1 module. So you have a pin named T1, you have a pin named ICP1. So hope you people know the role of this T1 pin and ICP1 pin, which we have already dealt with. So today we'll just learn what is the role of this pin, that is your OC1A pin and OC1B pin, right? Now these are the two pins which we also call it as PWM channel. Okay, so PWM, pulse width modulation channel. So we'll just learn how do we use this pin for your PWM generation, right? So that is what we will be looking into this video lecture. Okay, right. Now this output compare unit, so this is the module which helps in providing with PWM, right? Okay, so before getting into this OCU module and its registers and all, we just look into a bit of basic related to PWM, pulse width modulation. Okay, so normally if at all you want to design a pulse width modulation modulator and all, so we normally we use an operational amplifier. So I guess you people know the operation of the operational amplifier. So normally we use this 741 IC. So you know that for your op amp you have a non-inverting terminal and an inverting terminal, and of course you have a pin related to your VSAT, and that is positive VSAT, and you also have a pin related to negative VSAT, right? So these are the basic pins available with respect to your operational amplifier. Okay, now if at all you want to design this comparator using this operational amplifier, so what normally we do is we rig up our circuit, and if you want to use this op-amp as your comparator, normally what we do, we give some value in this pin, so which we'll just keep it as a static, and you know that your input, just assume that it won't vary between 0 to 5 volts. So that's the limitation which we are keeping. And in the other end I have an option of giving either for generating PWM, and this talking related to generating PWM, okay, right? So what I have is, if I just assume this to be my comparator, so this op-amp will act as a comparator, and we have already discussed how your analog comparator works, you know. So whenever the value, that is the voltage in your non-inverting terminal, is greater than the voltage applied to inverting terminal, your output will be equal to your Vsat, and if it is vice versa, your output will be equal to your minus Vsat and all. So assume that your minus Vsat is ground, so it goes to zero, like that. Okay, right. So with respect to this PWM, so what we'll do is, we just assume that in negative terminal, so we have some static value, or your DC input, which is between 0 to 5 volt, and in this non-inverting terminal, we just assume that we are giving a sawtooth. So you know, this is the normal diagram related to sawtooth. So where your the amplitude of your waveform is varying from 0 volt to 5 volt. Okay, so this is your continuous waveform, and this is your time axis, this is your amplitude axis. Okay, now if at all you give in one input is your sawtooth and in the other input you have a fixed value, so let us assume that this to be 1 volt, right? Now what will be your output in this case? So this is your normal comparator. So in output, depending upon your value in this terminal and in this terminal, your output will vary between your Vsat and ground. Okay, now if your value which you are applying to this plus, that is your non-inverting, is your sawtooth function, okay, right? So till it reaches 1 volt, okay, till this value reaches 1 volt, the output will be zero, right? Now the moment it reaches 1 volt and goes up to 5 volt, your output value will be in Vsat. That is your, over here let us assume that your Vsat is 5 volt. So it will be in 5 volt, it remains in 5 volt. The moment again your input in plus goes, input in this non-inverting goes less than your inverting, your output again it comes to low, that is your ground, and it remains in zero till the value in your non-inverting terminal goes beyond 1 volt. So that is what our consideration. So your output will be something like this. Okay, and this width, okay, so this depends upon what is the value you set over here, right? So 1 volt, okay, fine. So till it reaches 1 volt, the value will be zero, and beyond 1 volt to your 5 volt, the value will be high. So that's how your analog comparator works, right? Now this kind of waveform, you can call it as your pulse width modulated waveform. Now if I change the value over here in static with some 2 volt, so what it will do, it will definitely change the width of my off time and as well as the width of my on time. Okay, but you can just see that the frequency, that is your on time and off time, so this period, so that period will be equal to the frequency of this. Okay, so this time period will be equal to the time period from this point to this point. So your frequency, it remains constant, and if you want to change your on time and your off time, you just vary this static voltage, which you, that is your DC voltage, which you apply to your negative terminal, right? So this will give you a variable duty cycle. Okay, right? I hope you people know what is this duty cycle. So normally your duty cycle is represented as D, which is equal to on time by on time plus off time. So this is the general formula for the
duty cycle.
Okay, right. Now this particular waveforms, you just see that in your non-inverting terminal, we are trying to give some kind of sawtooth with a certain frequency, and in the inverting terminal, we are just keeping a constant value, and in the output, we are generating some kind of waveform, which we are calling it as your PWM, and this frequency is totally depending upon the frequency of this sawtooth waveform, and the width of your on time and off time is depending upon what value you are using for comparison and all. Okay, right. Now the same thing is not that always you apply your sawtooth waveform and your this the constant value to your inverting terminal and non-inverting terminal at all. So you can also swap it. So I can give the waveform to this also, and the static value, that is your the constant value, I can have it over here. The only thing is that your output will be of inverted, so it will be something like this. Okay, so when I put this over here and this constant value over here, right, your output will be only inverted. So your output, it can have an inverted output or it can have a non-inverted output. So you have two options available. Okay, right. Now these are general phenomena for generating your pulse width modulation. Okay, so this is what normally we use for generating your variable pulse width. Okay, right. Now over here you just see that we have used a sawtooth. You also have an option of using your triangular waveform also. So you have an option of using your triangular waveform. So your triangular waveform is something like this. Okay, right. So the same, you have your time axis, you have your amplitude, so going from 0 to your 5 volt. Now when you use your triangular waveform as one of the input of your comparator, and the other input you are using your the constant value, so you can see that you have a comparison in 2 points. One is when it is going in your upward direction, the other one is when it comes from your upward to down direction. Okay, so you have comparison at these two point. Then similarly, your output, depending upon the value in your non-inverting terminal, if it is greater than your inverting terminal, your output will be 1, and in the other case your output will be low. Right. Now this is how normally we generate our PWM. Okay, now the thing is that how these things are being generated by using your timer 1 module. So that is what we will see in the next video lecture.